What's up, man? This is Marcus. Obviously one of the dons of the new Dallas RDST. And so, you know, the dons start thinking, the Don RDST, you know, we had to take it over after that choke of missing all them threes. And I start thinking, I said, man, what is going on in H-Town? This is amazing. It says, Ayesha Curry's Houston restaurant bombarded with one-star reviews before opening. How do you give a review and it's not even open? Negative threes? Was it Ayesha Curry that broke the record for 27 consecutive missed threes? It wasn't her. So how does a whole city, without talking to each other at all, just a whole city say, you know what, everybody, somebody sitting in Katie, somebody sitting in Spring, somebody sitting in a Tray, somebody sitting in a Nickel, somebody sitting in Missouri City, all of them had that same thought at the same time. They say, you know what, man, that restaurant ain't open, man, but, man, I'm going on here, man. I'm going to take action, man. They beat us. You know, and I'm mad about that, man. You know, what make a whole bunch of individuals that don't even know each other literally come together and say, man, I'm finna hate on this. And I figured it out. I figured it out today. Is your city is pathetic in sports. It has a pathetic history, and it makes you bitter and just mad at everything. You're just mad at anybody that's winning. Especially Dallas, because we up north, we handling our business. We've been handling our business forever. We know winning. We have no reason to hate on H. That's all we know is winning. So that's what it is that y'all have a great long history of choking. Take Houston's own George Foreman, who really should have been known as the official GOAT of boxing. Ali took GOAT from Houston's boxing. And George is known for grills now. I have a couple in the kitchen. I don't even have to mention one of the greatest NCAA chokes in history to NC State by Five Slamma Jamma. And don't even mention football. Please don't ever mention professional Houston football.
They don't want it, baby. They don't want it. Fasten your seatbelts. It's playoff time. The Bills and the Oilers ready to get it on in an AFC wild card game. And the road to the Super Bowl, Project Pasadena, starts here.
The run and shoot never fired with more precision as Warren Moon completed 19 of 22 passes and leading the Oilers to touchdowns on all four of their first half possessions.
Looking, lofting it down near sideline. Jeffries at the five. He's in. Touchdown. Yep.
The Bills, meanwhile, could do no wrong with stars like Cornelius Bennett, Jim Kelly, and Thurman Thomas on the sidelines. Gutty backups like number 23, Kenneth Davis, continued to pave the comeback.
Kenneth freaking Davis.
3 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, Warren Moon watched his 32-point lead officially disappear. Incredible finish. In overcoming a 32-point deficit, Frank Reich and the Bills took their place in football lore as part of the greatest comeback in NFL history.
Who hadn't scored in the second half until right there.
And then the well-designed play by John Beilein.
Just this year, Houston stepping over each other in misery.
They don't want it, baby. They don't want it.
I would be evil to not give credit to one of the most decorated Olympians ever, Carl Lewis of Houston, a sprinter. Long jump champion. One of the best anchor legs ever. Houston would never let you down, literally, on an epic choke.
And the Rockets, red flag! I'll make up for it now. For the land of the free.
That was Sarge National Anthem. Written by Francis Scott off key. Those were last night's lowlights. They were last night's highlights.
That's on me, baby. You see what you're doing to the state? You see how the state look? I mean, just giving Texas a bad name, huh?
Okay.
Moon up. A lot of Houston fans hate Dallas because we super represent the world and Texas right on the biggest stages. Michael Johnson swagging in his gold shoes before he breaks Olympic records and world records. How we do it. In football, Dallas had to make up for the Houston Buffalo all-time recorded historical choke. It was not Dallas who messed up the Texas Super Bowl. It was Houston.
Ken Norton knocked Jim Kelly out of the game in the second quarter, and the defense forced a Super Bowl record 9 turnovers.
They're back on top now, and they should stay there a while. Wow.
Jimmy Johnson's taking his team from the absolute worst to the absolute best in 4 years. And Dallas, your Cowboys are the champions.
You know, every now and then, my boy BT, he will try to keep it real. Just, and you know, when the moon's aligned and the sun come out perfect, no clouds in the skies, and it's a full moon, BT will keep it real. He really will. And this is one of those on crazy days. Growing up in Houston, you either love the Cowboys or you hated them. I'm willing to admit, there are way more Cowboy haters in Houston than Cowboy lovers. I'm going to stop there. Man, my boy say, man, I'm willing to admit. Well, you admitted it, didn't you? I appreciate that. That's big of you. You know, I'm still shocked, you know, but every now and then I will say, man, my boy BT will admit it. Already, BT. Already, man. I feel that. That's real. Man, I'm out, man.
Made me sick with all that old